Yeah, one day we were up on Tam with our wheelbarrows, racing through things like Northside Trail, down to Thousand S's, and these other kids from across the county, must have been from Mill Valley or something like that, came across on bicycles. And they had these big clunker bicycles with big fat tires that looked really stupid. But that was the early part of mountain biking. And a lot of people were pretty into that and excited about it, but we were, you know, generating a pretty good following and a pretty good circuit of races on the wheelbarrows all over Tam. And it really took away some of that excitement for following one wheel, two hands, 2 feet. Suddenly it's two wheels and you're riding along on a bicycle on dirt. Didn't make any sense. Bikes don't go on dirt. Wheelbarrows go on dirt. Quite young, after working on a job site and with a kind of bored bunch of kids, and started looking around for things to do and realized there was a wheelbarrow, and started racing laps around this job site and got the great idea of driving our pickup trucks up to the top of Mount Tam, jumping out with our wheelbarrows and running as fast as we possibly could down through all the different trails up on Tam.
I talk about mountain biking without talking about Marin. You can't talk about Marin without talking about wheelbarrowing.
We had our annual wheelbarrow race on a trail that we called Snake Pit. And over time, more and more, there were bicycles racing down that. And they started calling that trail Repack for some reason. Something about having to repack their hubs after racing down this intense trail. Well, we were racing that for years ahead of those guys. My beautiful wife, Christine, and I met in high school, of course, and our relationship and our family has grown through the years, much of it around wheelbarrowing. She thought I was crazy to start with, but over time realized that it's just a great way to be out in the outdoors.
You know, once wheelbarrowing started to become a thing of the past, he got kind of big. He was a little bit around the middle, but I just moved on. You know, I tried to serve healthy food at home and buy more salad.
So back in the day, before the times of mountain biking, my dad actually used to be like a professional wheelbarrow racer. I always saw pictures and videos of it, like the old like rolly clips, and it just looked so stupid. I never wanted to do it. But then like one day I was sick and tired of riding, and a few buddies invited me out on the Wednesday evening wheelbarrow ride. And I tried it, and I was impressed. I loved it. It was sick. We sent down all these sick trails doing gnarly grinds and slides on it. Could have been any better than that.
Turns out my son John has gotten into wheelbarrowing, and sort of a next generation type of sport. But also, like me, found that there was something lacking in mountain biking. A bit of a danger and the element of being out there by yourself with your own bucket over a single wheel and running through the woods. So he was looking for something more than he could get on a bicycle, and has kind of revitalized that whole sport here in the county.
I've been mountain biking for a while, and I tried this thing called enduro, a form of mountain biking and where you just race down the hills, climb back up the stages. I'm like, this is kind of boring. So I'm like, why not try this on my wheelbarrow? So I brought out my wheelbarrow one day, pushed up to the top of the stages and just pinned it down, and it was just way more fun.
We can dance if we want to, we can leave your friends behind, cause your friends don't dance, and if they don't dance, well, they're no friends of mine. See, we can go where we want to, places they will never find, and we can act like we come from out of this world, leave the real one far behind. We can dance.
trails were real good today. Totally got pitted going down this one root section. Super big rush, it was sweet.
Say, we can act if we want to, if we don't, nobody will. And you can act real rude and totally removed, and I can act like an imbecile. Say, we can dance, everything's out of control. We can dance, we're doing it from pole to pole. We can dance, everybody look at your hands. We can dance.
Well, I like using, like, maybe like a plastic bucket, kind of lightweight, but with a bigger wheel. Bigger wheel, but still small in diameter, but thick, like sidewall height. And then I usually do a full face because you never know when that thing's just going to come up and hit you in the head or something like that. Or like you go down and eat it, you know? And maybe some knee pads because like you can like send on a turn and get loose. And then your wheelbarrow is going down the hill and you're sliding on your knees. So it's like you need all that gear. It's like protection. I mean, I'd rather be safe than sorry. It's a dangerous sport, but it's fun doing it.
We can dance if we want to. We can leave your friends behind. Because your friends don't dance, and if they don't dance, well, that's no friends of mine. I see. We can dance, everything's out of control. But we can dance, we're doing it from pole to pole. But we can dance.
Yeah, stoked, pitted, rad, awesome, chunky, tacky. Dusty, soily. Oh, it just goes on and on.
Will it save the dance? Yes, it saved the dance. Will it save the dance? Will it save the dance? Yes, it saved the dance.
We're all afternoon on this great dinner, and we're sitting down. I got this beautiful meal, and then it's like, oh, dude, have you seen the new, you know, super knobby 6-inch, you know, squeezy, you know, tires? And then Ryan's like, oh no, dude, because like there's these 7.5 with 8mm flexion stuff coming out the side of it. And I'm like, great, because I've just spent all this time on dinner. It becomes all wheelbarrow all the time.
The best part about wheelbarrowing is spending time in nature and spending time with the bros and the babes.
So days when I'm just like slammed in work and stressed, like I can't concentrate, I just go and take my wheelbarrowing and, you know, just go wheelbarrow trails. It just calms me down. Without that, I mean, I can't do homework, can't write any essays, do anything like that. So without wheelbarrowing, I'd be like a shell of a man.
He doesn't even like girls. I don't even think he wants to go to the prom. I mean, he's all into wheelbarrowing all the time. It's kind of embarrassing. I don't know. You know, what are you going to say? It's your own son. You don't want to be like, my kid's a geek, but he loves it. You know?